Get the shot off. Crowder checks the clock, gets it to Isaiah. Deep three. Oh! 50 points for Isaiah Thomas.
Highest scoring output of any Celtic in franchise history. MVP chance broke out. What does that mean to you?
A blessing from God. I mean, you dream about things like that, especially playing for the Celtics, getting MVP chance, all the great players that did it before me. It's a blessing.
Challenging them. This dude is something special. He's phenomenal right now. He's averaging 29 a game. He shoots 46% from the field, 38% from three-point range, 91.5% from the free throw line. And Boston is the number two seed in the Eastern Conference. So in that regard, he is a legitimate MVP candidate who deserves worthy consideration.
You don't think someday I'm like, yeah, damn. Like, when I look, I'm amazed for you to make it to the fucking NBA at 5'9". And be the last pick. I mean, you want a guy's favorite, man. You gotta know that.
Look, man, you're blessed way beyond belief, man. That's the that you did that you wouldn't talk about. That you'll never really talk about, man. I was the last pick in the draft. I was when he's supposed to be in the NBA. Man, guys.
Isaiah Thomas, as Floyd Mayweather told us on this show a couple weeks ago, is a legitimate MVP candidate. In a league where there are 30 teams and 16 of them make the postseason, 16, that's over half the teams make the playoffs. If you don't make the playoffs, you're not an MVP candidate anyway. So you might as well wait till the end of the finals to see who the real MVP is every year just about. No, every year it's really LeBron. But let me put that aside because that's not the way the award works. Look at the numbers. You mentioned they're second in the conference. They don't have any superstars on that team. And by the way, I was on LA radio when Isaiah Thomas was a free agent every day yelling at the Lakers, sign Isaiah Thomas, and he's cheap. He's 25 years old at the time. He's in his prime. You get him locked up for the next 4 years, under $10 million. As it turned out, it was under $7 million a year. He is an underrated decision maker with the ball, like Harden and Westbrook and all the great modern point guards. They have to be able to draw double. They have to draw the defense in because they create penetration off the dribble. He can do that. They have to then be able to finish. He can do that. They have to be able to shoot free throws when they get to the line. He can do that. They have to be able to shoot from the outside. He can do that. Many of what I just mentioned, he can do better than Westbrook or Harden according to the percentages. What he doesn't do is rebound the ball. I mean, his assists are lower than those guys, but his rebounds are very low. But that doesn't mean your team's not getting the rebound. That means you're not getting the rebound, which is the problem with just doing counting numbers in the NBA. He's actually a more efficient player than those guys by many of the percentage numbers. He's got his team without any other real star players. Apologies to Al Horford, who I like a lot, but is not a superstar type player. Second in the conference, and on top of all that, he's tiny. There's something about the narrative of the situation that writers love, that people love in an MVP conversation. So it's not just the numbers and crunching that and everything, because he's similar to those guys in that way. He's also 5'9". The story itself is appealing. That this guy can be that good, have that positive an impact on the fortunes of his team at his size is insane. Wow. And deserves appreciation and consideration.
Same routine. I know how to work. I work like a pro. No matter what the circumstances is, it's getting the gym and get better. I get it on my own.
Pop a perky just to start up. Pop two cups of purple just to warm up.
Two cups, drink.
I heard your bitch, she got that water.
Splash,
drip,
drip,
woo. Splash. Ay. Slippery, whoa. Excuse me, please me,
please.
I'm up, oh, believe me, believe me,
believe me.
Get beat, cause I'm flexing Rory.
Skirt.
You can bet on me.
Skirt.
Hey, tater tot, fuck niggas on my radar watch.
Watch him
crack a die, hunter, turn him to some gator shots. I stop watch,
ice.
Round 10 o'clock.
Hey.
Five o'clock, 6 o'clock. I'm gon' pop.
scales, fish scale, big weight, fish, iceberg, ice, ice tray, woo plug call. Call, try the front, I don't need it, brr, I don't need it, brr, pocket strong, wrist anemic, stop, get freezing, freezing. Y'all don't need it, they don't need it, see the front, Auntie Greta, sir, you Perkins. Auntie Eva, if she got a pound, she might just serve it. Pop a Perky, just a starter. Pop it, pop it, pop two cups of purple, just a warm up. Two cups, drink. I heard your bitch, she got that water. Splash, drip, drip, woo. Splash. Ay. Slippery, whoa, excuse me. Slippery, slip. She numbing me, that tongue on me. Honestly, she fuck with me, a wife to be. White in Italy, but her for my
ass. Look, I got two orders. Watch it chill with me. She's a woman, it is a bill to me.
For throttle, she swallowed the bottle, I'm all on her ovaries. I gave her some dollars, I Gucci the color, now she can't get over me. She wanna dose me, just hop in the ghost with me. Perky and Molly don't fuck with nobody, these bitch ass nigga ain't silent. Running your house with pumps in the shadow, your mama might be up inside it. Cars robotic, bad bitch with a body, but really don't care nothing about it. Capping and popping, I seen it in my seat, I could have pulled up and just shot you.
Thomas on the drive,
Jason Terry, Brandon Roy, Nate Robinson, those guys looked out for me when I was growing up. And their message to me was, look out for the next guy.